First and foremost, you know, we should understand what are boundaries. Boundaries are nothing but paradigms. Boundaries. Boundaries का मतलब है paradigms, एक सोच, एक काम करने का तरीका. Anything that you do will form boundaries. You know, like if you start working in one city called Mumbai, and then you work there for a very long period of time, then you believe that you can only work in Mumbai. Similarly in other cities. Suppose you start taking people who are your relatives, that becomes your boundaries, because when you practice something for a long period of time, it becomes a habit, and that is what is boundaries all about. Now, where are these boundaries? The boundaries are not physical boundaries. There are no physical boundaries that stops you from taking non-relatives. There are no boundaries that stops you from going into another market. There are no boundaries that stops you from taking challenges in life. So we all create our own mental boundaries. All boundaries are mental boundaries. And many years ago, I learned from the great Joel Barker one of the most important aspects, you know, of how to break boundaries. And you have to ask the paradigm shift question. Now you're already in your boundary. You're already inside your boundary. It could be an income boundary. It could be a territory boundary. It could be a product boundary. It could be a recruitment boundary, or it could be any kind of boundaries. But if you have to break this, you have to ask a fundamental question to yourself. And the question goes like this: what today is impossible to do in my life, but if it could be done, would fundamentally change what I do? Aaj meri zindagi mein impossible kya hai, agar maine wo kar diya to meri zindagi ki kaya palat ho jayegi. Now what happens when you ask this question: what today is impossible to do in my life? Now suppose you were taking only relatives in your business, what today is impossible to do in my life? Impossible to take professionals in my life. But if it could be done, it will fundamentally shift you and take you to the next level. So there are physical boundaries. You know, some people have weights, you know, so you're 100 kilos. So you must ask yourself, what today is impossible to do in the next 3 months? And if I could do that, I will fundamentally shift to another paradigm. And it says in 3 months, it's impossible to reduce 25 kilos. But if it could be done, it will fundamentally take you to another level of business. So all throughout my life, how did I break my boundaries? I asked this question. When I used to make 5,000 rupees a day, I said, what today is impossible to do in my life, but if it could be done, would fundamentally change what I do? I said, making 50,000 rupees a month. When I used to make 50,000 rupees a month, I asked this question, what today is impossible to do? And I said, 5 lakhs a month. When I asked this question, what today is impossible, I said 10 lakh rupees in a month is impossible to do, and I kept on asking this question to my health, to my relationship, to my people, to the territory, to the products, to services. What today is impossible? Because the moment you ask what today is impossible, you start going to the edge or the boundary of your present boundary, or the edge or the end of your present boundary. Standing at the end of the present boundary, you will be in a position to see the next boundary. So keep asking this question again and again and again, what today is impossible to do. The other reason why I was in a position to break a whole lot of boundaries is because of my value systems. One of the values that I practice is disregard difficulties. I have an inherent inability to understand difficulties. Like if my job is not over, then I will not sleep and I'll work throughout the night till morning. So I do not understand what is difficulties. A large number of people believe not sleeping is a difficulty. You know, working hard is a difficulty. Going to new markets is a difficulty. All this difficulty is in the mind. So mental boundaries are broken by having core values. And I have this beautiful core value which I say, disregard difficulties. The other core value that I follow is saying no to conventional thinking. Conventionally and traditionally, what has been accepted by the society, I do not believe in them. Paramparagat jo chali aa rahi hai, usme main believe nahi karta hu. Main paramparao ko todne mein believe karta hu, traditions ko todne mein believe karta hu. So anything that has been happening traditionally, so if somebody says this has been happening for the last 10 years, I say, why has it been happening for the last 10 years and it should be broken right now? So say no to conventional thinking, you know. But when you are going to break conventional thinking, remember the difficulty that comes is you are going to be a loner. You are always going to be a loner, and amongst the crowd, you are going to be a loner. Whenever you do something that is contrary to society, you will be alone. So if you are not comfortable being alone, if you're not comfortable having tremendous opposition to your ideas and philosophies, if you're not comfortable with all those people leaving you and going, if because you stood for an idea, people are going to leave you because they don't agree to this idea that you are accepting right now, because you're breaking the law, you're breaking the rule, you're breaking the convention. So you're going to be a loner in life. So one of the most important principles in life is that if you're not ready to be a loner in life, which is a leadership ability, you should not break conventional wisdom. So only people who have broken laws, only people who have broken physical boundaries, mental boundaries, emotional boundaries, psychological boundaries, economic boundaries, are the people who are ready to be alone, are the people who are ready to say no to difficulties, are the people who are going to say no to conventional thinking, and are the people who are ready to take the pain and undergo the difficulties and challenges, because it's a transformation game. And it is going to be a very painful game. So if you can do this and ask this fundamental question, what today is impossible to do in my life or in my business or with my wife or with my children or with my subordinate or with my market or with my colleague or with my life, what today is impossible to do? And if I do the impossible, I will constantly keep breaking the boundaries. That's how I have done it. All the very best, and thank you.